Real music, real interviews, real information. That's why we call it Real Gospel with the Xman.
Welcome back to Real Gospel. It's the X-Man, your radio minister of music. Do you watch the show Greenleaf on the OWN Network? If you don't, you're missing out on an excellent show with excellent writing about a church family, a first family. Anyway, I won't spoil it. But here is one of the songs from one of the artists who is on that show. It's Pattie LaBelle featuring Deborah Joy Winans. Yes, Pattie's on the show as well. And on the other side of this song called Changed, we're going to talk once again to Deborah Joy Winans of Greenleaf.
Changed
Real Gospel is the place where God gets the glory and artists tell their stories. It's always good to check in with previous guests. And you may know her from the own network show, Greenleaf. She's also a recording artist, although she doesn't want to claim to be a recording artist. You didn't think I remembered that, did you? Yes, I'm talking about the one and only Deborah Joy Winans. Welcome back to Real Gospel.
Thank you. How are you?
I am excellent. And, you know, you've been doing some major things since the last time we spoke. Yes.
You know, I'm trying.
Mm-hmm. So, first and foremost, I'm loving the song with Pattie LaBelle. It is just such an awesome song. And you are singing one of gospel's, music's greats, the song Changed. And how'd that come about?
Yes. Just our amazing writer. That episode was written by Chris Turner Towner, who is a part of the writer's room as well as an EP on the show. And she just understands gospel music. She understands the show. And when she wrote that song in, I thought, oh my goodness, this is going to be phenomenal. So we're super excited we were able to record such a legendary song with such a legendary artist.
Yeah, you're right. Had you known Pattie before this?
No, I met Pattie through the show, and Miss Pattie is fabulous from beginning to end. The moment she walked onto our set, she just brought joy and life, and she's fabulous.
Yeah, she is. And so, is this the only collaboration? This is from the soundtrack, correct?
Yes.
Okay, for this season of Greenleaf. And so, are there any other songs that you've done on the soundtrack?
Yes, I have three other songs on the season 3 soundtrack that are just me. But this is the only collaboration I was able to do that's on the soundtrack. And, you know, Miss Pattie is someone to collaborate with. So it's been such an incredible time. I mean, the day in the studio was just fantastic.
Yeah. So explain to the listeners, they'll have to go to my podcast to hear the previous interview where you wanted nothing to do with becoming a recording artist because you come from a family of legends in the music industry and you didn't want any part of that. So you go from not wanting any part of that to now doing another song on another soundtrack for the second season of Greenleaf. How do you feel?
It's amazing. And really what I've learned is that whatever God gives you, you know, you should use them to the best of your ability whenever you can. I just never had a passion to sing. And so I love my family's music. I love growing up watching them perform and sing and write. I just never had a passion to do it. And when Greenleaf came about, I thought, wow, this is really strange. Something that I never wanted to do, now I have to do a whole lot of, and I have to do it at a level of expectation that felt like a lot of pressure, because people do know my family, and I think my family's incredible. And so it was just, I felt like I had to learn how to, it was sink or swim. It was either get it right now, or we gonna see that you're not what you need to be. So the moral of that story is to use every gift God has given you to the best of your ability so that you're ready and prepared for all that He has for you. Don't limit yourself and don't limit God.
Yeah. I'm looking at the soundtrack right now. You also do Don't Knock. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You also do Healing. And wow, this seems like something else. You're also on When You Hear of My Home Going. Yeah, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you've got a lot going on.
Yeah,
here.
Yeah, so I have three solos on the new soundtrack, and then the duet with the one and only Miss Pattie LaBelle.
Yes. So now let's talk about your character on OWN. You know, people want to know, your character has taken a dramatic turn in terms of motherhood, and this is well written. I just have to say, it's a joy to watch. So for people who probably haven't watched Greenleaf, talk about your character this season and how you have evolved in this role.
Absolutely. This season, we see Charity, up till this point, she's actually beginning to grieve. And she's beginning to really feel the pain of everything that has happened to her. She has lost her marriage. She has lost her best friend. She has had a child, and she has lost a child. And so with all that has happened, she kind of sort of tried to keep moving as if she was invincible. And this season, she's learning that she's not, and now she's trying to find her place in her family, her place in the world. She's trying to figure out where she belongs. She is grieving the loss of so many big things in her life, and she's losing her way.
Yeah, yeah. Can you speak, I know you can't reveal too much about what's taking place with your character, but about the turmoil taking place between Charity and her husband / ex-husband, and the fact that he came out to be gay, and now there's a struggle and a tug of war taking place over parenting.
Absolutely. And Charity's biggest thing is, you know, our marriage is gone. We're supposed to be co-parents, but then in season two, you see that Kevin just up and leaves without any notice. He disappears. He leaves his job at the church. He leaves his child, and he's gone. And so this season, he comes back very demanding, as if he didn't take a leave of absence from being a father. And so there's that turmoil, that struggle of who do you think you are, just marching back in and demanding to be a part of your son's life. How can I trust you right now? How can I trust that you'll be there? How can I trust that I can leave our son with you and you won't just disappear? And then on top of that, she has to deal with the fact that he has decided to start a relationship with her divorce attorney. So not only have you left her and you've left this marriage and you've abandoned your child, you have gotten into a relationship with the very person that helped steal your divorce. So that's a lot that she has to deal with, and she's breaking down.
Yeah, you got, to say the least. All right, I know that's sort of it right now in a nutshell. The last time we spoke, you were also involved in a play. Is there anything that you're doing right now in between recording, in between acting? What else do you have going on?
I was actually very grateful to have a little bit of a hiatus from work. It's been nonstop for the past 3 years. And so I've just been with my husband traveling, relaxing, doing some other things, some writing, some behind the scenes sort of things. And so that's been really, really nice. And now we just have to gear up for season four.
Wow. Right around the corner. Is there a solo project, your own project in the works? Come on. Come on. I know you're fighting it. I know you are. Your Uncle BB with his song Laughter, and your Aunt Cece with her song with the Clark Sisters, and now she's got Nashville Live going on. We've got to hear, well, we're already hearing from you, but come on, there's got to be something coming from you in the near future. Something else.
You know, I will leave that up to the Lord.
That's a church answer.
It's not something I'm pursuing, but you know, if it happens, it'll happen.
That's a good old-fashioned church answer. Anyway, thank you so much. I know that you are extremely busy, and I really appreciate the opportunity to speak with you yet again. It's been a pleasure. So for those of you whom have not been watching Greenleaf, please check it out. It's on the OWN network. And every time I see Keith David, I think about the show Platoon. The movie Platoon.
Yes.
I think about the Cartoon Network. And every time I see, now what's her name? Who plays your mother?
Lynn Whitfield.
Lynn Whitfield. Every time I see her, I think about Thin Line Between Love and Hate.
Yes.
I can't help it.
I have an all-star cast. It's been such an incredible journey.
Yeah.
So thank you. Thank you for playing the music. Thank you for your time. You know, I always appreciate it and always love talking to you. So thank you so much.
You're welcome. Where can the listeners find out more about you and the music?
You can find me on Instagram at Deborah Joy Winans. That's the long Deborah, D-E-B-O-R-A-H. Or on Twitter, Deborah J. Winans. Facebook, Deborah Joy Winans. And live tweet with us on Wednesdays, 10 p.m., 9 central on OWN. That's when you will see Greenleaf, and that's when we will be live tweeting. So watch with us, talk to us, let us know what you're thinking.
All right. Thank you so much for spending time with us on Real Gospel.
Thank you. Have a good one.
Since we have a little time, why don't we play Deborah Joy Winans' The Master's Calling? Choirs are singing this song once again all over the nation. She made it famous again. This is the song that if you go back and listen to my previous interview with her, she says she didn't want to have anything to do with singing and gospel music, but yet God had other plans for her. This is her debut single from a few years ago, The Master's Calling. Deborah Joy Winans, I'm the X-Man, and this is Real Gospel.
Listen while you still can hear. Listen while you still can hear the Master's call. The Master's call.
Yeah. The Master's Calling. Deborah Joy Winans. You can find her on the TV show Greenleaf. She didn't want to have anything to do with singing gospel music because she comes from a musical family. She wanted to pave her own way. She ended up on the show Greenleaf, and God had other plans. God said otherwise. You know what's up next? The real flashback song of the hour. And you know what? Why don't I take your request for the song right now? Reach out to me right now on my Facebook page, Real Gospel with the X-Man, or tweet me at Real Gospel X-Man. I want to know what flashback song, what traditional gospel song you want to hear. And if you missed this interview with Deborah Joy Winans, you can check out the podcast by going to my website, realgospelwiththexman.com.
You're listening to Real Gospel with the X-Man.